Screen printers love Smart Designer, mainly because it automates many of the tedious production tasks that are required in order to get a graphic ready for color separations for screen printing. So I'm going to walk you through a typical workflow on how to prep a graphic for screen printing using Smart Designer. Now, the first thing that's important is we need to have our graphic converted to spot colors. Now, this particular design is coming from Sport Studio number 1, so this particular art volume already has spot colors in it. But let's say all these graphics had a combination of spot colors, process colors, RGB colors. What can we do to resolve that? Well, the easiest thing to do is in Smart Designer under Color Conversion. We can just go over here and say Convert to Spot Colors, pick the spot color palette we want, hit Apply, and it'll automatically color separate the graphic. So that's an awesome feature for taking graphics that are not suitable for screen printing and converting them into spot colors. Now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how we can set up a halftone. So first thing, I'm just going to take the entire graphic and I'm going to ungroup everything, and then I'm going to isolate the part that I want to be a halftone. So it's going to be this color blue right here. And this is a different blue than this blue. So what I can do is hold down my shift key and my right mouse button, and I can drag and drop color from one object to another. So we've kind of manually merged these two together, and I'm going to select just this object and apply the halftone. So we'll go over here to printing and cutting. We'll select the feature for create halftones. The software is going to tell me, hey, you need to have a PostScript printer, so it gives me a little message for that. It's going to say, what kind of halftone do we want to do? Do we want to do simple spot color print on light garments? Do we want to do detailed spot color print on light garments? We've got all kinds of presets that are set up, and that's what's going to set up the frequencies and angles for screen printing halftones. We can also pick the style of dot. We can go in and pick our tint percentage, so I'll say 65%. We're going to apply that halftone only to the fill color. It's even going to recommend the screen mesh for my particular design. So we'll go ahead and click on apply, and we've created the halftone. So it's the same color as this blue, it's just a shade, and it's going to be printed out as a dot color, a dot pattern. So the next thing I want to do is I want to merge colors. I'm looking at the design and I can see this is a different colored blue than this colored blue. So what I might want to do is make that a halftone as well. And I can easily do that by merging colors. So we'll go over here to color conversion. We'll select merge colors. Here's all the colors in my design. I've got white, I've got two blues, and I've got a half tone of blue, and I have gray. So I'm going to select this blue right here, and I'm going to select the other blue with my control key now, or they're both going to be selected. I'm going to hit apply, and it's automatically going to merge that color together, and it's even going to create the half tone for that particular gradient fill effect. So the next thing I want to do is I want to create trapping. Trapping is a deliberate overlapping of inks when we're printing onto different garments so we don't get a white space in between the colors. So we're actually printing a little bit over the edge between two different colors. Smart Designer's got a very powerful trapping function. I can either trap the entire image or I can trap by selected object. And what I'm going to do next is I'm going to trap by selected object. So I'm going to trap just this white outline here. I'm going to select that object there, hold down my shift key, select that. Then what we're going to do is we're going to go down here to printing and cutting. We're going to select the option for trap colors. And then what it's going to do, it's going to ask me for my specific preferences. So I'm going to only trap the selected objects. I can trap objects without an outline. In order to trap in CorelDRAW, we have to have an outline on our object. If we don't have an outline on the object, Smart Designer is going to put an outline of the same color as the fill color and trap that. So it actually creates an outline for me. I can trap by percentage of outline width, or I can trap everything by a specific width or percentage of outline width. And we're going to go ahead and hit apply, and we're going to trap those colors. And if I right mouse click on here, I can see that it set all the outlines to overprint. So that set my trapping automatically. Now the other thing people want to do is they want to print a white underbase or flash base when they're printing dark garments. That's a solid white underlay. So Smart Designer also has a very powerful function for printing a flash base. Go and show you how that works. I'm going to go over here and I'm going to say create flash base. And we're going to decide which colors are going to show through. We might want to have the garment color show through. So let's say this was printing on a gray t-shirt, and maybe this blue area, we want that to be the garment color coming through. And the way we can do that is we can check the box for remove substrate color. Let's click on that. We'll click on the little dropper, and it's going to exclude that color from my flash base. It even tells me with a visual reference. I can set up a spread or a choke. All the different variables that I need. I don't even have to have a solid color flash base. I can have it as a tint percentage if I want. So we'll go ahead and apply our flash base there. Hit apply. What the software is doing is it's making a composite black image. It's putting that on a separate page. So here's your original image right here. You're going to print out the color separations from that original image. Here's your flash base. You're going to print out just that page as a composite image. Now, the last step that I'm probably going to want to do is I want to create a color separation mark. So we'll go ahead and insert separation marks here. Very flexible feature. So we'll click on insert set marks, pick the style of mark, we'll pick the locations of the mark. If we want to rotate the second mark, any kind of parameters we want, we'll just go ahead and hit apply. It'll create those separation marks. And these are just on-screen objects. So you can ungroup them and move them around if you want. You're completely flexible in terms of that. And then we'll go ahead and show you what the color separations look like on this. So we'll go to File, Print. In CorelDRAW X5, it's a little bit different. We go ahead and click on Color. You click on Print Separations. You've got the little flyout window here, so you can expand and contract that. And you can actually see the various color separations for each one of the color layers in this particular image. In fact, we can scroll through here and you can see the white underbase. There you go. So that's how the typical workflow in Smart Designer for screen printing goes. And I think if you're a screen printer, it is a really big deal to have Smart Designer. It just streamlines your workflow. It reduces so many of those manual production steps. It's very automated and it'll greatly reduce the art production time it takes to create your screens.